15 laps, and off the front row in car 76 is Tom Watson Jr.
A big field of speed cars too. In fact, 14 cars to face the starters. Tom Watson Jr. takes the lead, moving down the back straight, and this is going to be a ripper. Toby Gibb, the young 16-year-old sensation, in second place. Michael Good in car number 9 in third, and then back to Neverlands in car 14. In the foul house they go. There's a great shot of our cameras by the Channel 7 crew. Four or five cars they've collected as they move into pit's bend now. It's Tom Watson Jr., former WA speed car champion. The car's prepared for racing by his father, Tom Sr. In second place is the 16-year-old Toby Gibb. Michael Good, car number 14, is Neverlands. Rubbing wheels.
Cars.
Just a little love tap that was. There's number 6, the veteran Ron Glazebrook in the car he imported from America.
Tell you what, it might be a little love tap, but geez, you'd take a deep breath, wouldn't you?
You certainly would. That gets the adrenaline rush going pretty well as we move down the through foul house corner. Tom Watson Jr. in 76, back to car number 16, Toby Gibb. And this is a great speed car spectacle. The speed cars burning up the Claremont track. Out of turn 4 and down the main straight. 4 laps down and 11 to go on the speed car feature race. Back to Toby Gibb, back to car number 14. That driver is Neverlands, but there's absolutely no doubt about Tom Watson Jr. He's a veteran speed car driver, and at the moment he looks very relaxed behind the steering wheel.
He's also taking what he can of the rough track at the bottom. It's fairly slippery in the middle at the moment. There's no perfect line for them. Got to make the best of what's available there. And Tom Watson Jr. is an expert at doing that.
That's right. This is when you work out if you've had good tyres, because the track now has been worn in well and truly by the sprint cars. There's Neverlands in car 14. They have 9 laps to go. It's Tom Watson Jr. out in front. Toby Gibb in second place. Neverlands. Then we find car number 9, Michael Good. Michael Figlamini's in this race, and he's up in fourth place. But this is a ripper race at the halfway mark as they come out of turn 4. This is brilliant. Tom Watson Jr. leading Toby Gibb, Neverlands, and Michael Figlamini.
And in the first heat of the speed cars in this meeting, it was Toby Gibb who held out Tom Watson Jr. for second place.
He certainly did. So here we find a change in reversal in positions, but Michael Figlamini, the national champion, starting to make his presence felt to the right of screen in fourth place. So it's Watson Jr. Then Figlamini grabs third place. Neverlands on the outside, and Toby Gibb's found the going tough, and Figlamini's just grabbed second place. This is world-class speedway, no doubt about that. Figlamini from the back mark, he's up in second place. The race leader, Tom Watson Jr., but he won't be for long. They have 6 laps to go at this man-made hill in Claremont, and Michael Figlamini's just finished a 30-lap sprint car race and driving well.
Yeah, and have a look at how he used the rough stuff up the top to get the extra traction, and he's made up something like 40 metres in one corner.
Yeah, brilliant speedway action as Michael Figlamini takes the lead. Second place, Matt Watson Jr., and back to Neverlands. Neverlands is up there now, and they come out of turn number 4. That's 10 down and 5 to go, and it's Michael Figlamini, the Australian speed car champion, on his way to win this feature race, no doubt about that, as they come out of turn number 4. 4 laps to go on the speed car feature race, and Michael Figlamini driving an absolute treat. Neverlands in second place. Third place man is Tom Watson Jr. He found the going tough. 3.5 laps left to go, and the speed car feature race is an absolute lung buster.
Well, you said no doubt about it for Figlamini. I don't think anybody's told Neverlands that yet.
No, Neverlands is starting to pour the pressure on. The track is really suiting them as they go through Foulhouse Corner, and the yellow lights come on as the car is spun on Foulhouse Corner.
Nothing too serious about the spin. The car just parked off the track. But they will go to an Indian Fire restart with 3 laps to go, and that will give Neverlands a chance. So it's Michael Figlamini who gets them away. Neverlands hot as hammer, a 3-lap restart. Tony Scott was the driver who backed off onto the infield.
And you're dead right, Neverlands uses it to his advantage. He's on the outside of Figlamini now as they go through Foulhouse Corner. This is brilliant speed car action. Well, David called it right as they move down the back straight, and it's Neverlands out in front of the national speed car champion. A virtual match race. 2.5 laps left to go as they move out of turn number 4. It's Lance out in front, Figlamini underneath him, but this is brilliant speed car racing now.
And you may not think it, but the car on the outside actually has the advantage. He goes further, but he goes faster because he has the traction from the rough stuff under the right rear tyre.
Yes, he has the high line. 1 lap to go, the white flag from Trevor Newman, and the speed cars have done the meeting absolutely proud. Graham Jones is up in third place now as they thunder down the back straight the last time. It's Neverlands, the Western Australian star in car number 14, comes out of turn number 4 and across the line from the Australian champion Michael Finglamini, and in back in third place is number 4 Graham Jones, and that is a brilliant time for the last three laps of 54.6.